shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. None like you. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you're higher than any other. Our God is healer. Awesome in power, our God. Our God. Into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. None like you. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer. Awesome in power, our God. Our God. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you're higher than any other. Our God is healer. Awesome in power. Our God. Our God.
Just to get me there.
Just to get me there.
apple of God's eye, children. Wow, what a wonderful day to be alive. Today we'll be talking about joy of God's glory. But before we start, let's have a quick word of prayer. Father, in Jesus' name, Father, we thank you for this day. Thank you for the opportunity to be alive. Thank you for all the joy you filled our hearts with. As we learn at your feet today, teach us something new. Give us understanding and let your joy fill our hearts, oh God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. So we'll be taking our Bible text from Psalm 8, verse 1 to 9. And I will be reading from the International Children's Bible. Please get your Bible and read along with me. Lord, our Master, your name is the most wonderful name in all the earth. It brings you praise in heaven above. You have taught children and babies to sing praises to you. This is because of your enemies. And so you silence your enemies and destroy those who try to get even. I look at the heavens which you made with your hands. I see the moon and stars which you created. But why is man important to you? Why do you take care of human beings? You made man a little lower than the angels, and you crowned him with glory and honor. You put him in charge of everything you made. You put all things under his control. All the sheep, the cattle, the wild animals, the birds in the sky, the fish in the sea, and everything that lives underwater. Lord, our Master, your name is the most wonderful name in all the earth. Wow, what a wonderful scripture we have there. So we'll be discussing joy of God's glory. Let's start with our memory verse. We'll be taking our memory verse from Psalm 16, verse 11. Please read with me. You will show me the path of life. In your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Let's take it again. Psalm 16, verse 11. You will show me the path of life. In your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures forevermore. There's a truth. There's something I want you to hold on to as we study today. That the joy of God's glory is the path to victory. So what do we mean by joy of God's glory? The joy of the Lord is our strength. In Nehemiah 8:11, we're told that the joy of the Lord is our strength. As children of God, we should always look for joy that comes from His glory. We should be willing to give everything for His glory. We should look out for His glory. We should do things that will attract His glory to us. We should look for things that will draw us close to His glory. So what is joy? I'll say joy is that emotion you get when you're experiencing something great or wonderful. It is that thing, that feeling you have, is that thing you feel inside of you. Let's say, for example, your mommy or daddy came home and said, oh, you know what you're getting for Christmas? You're getting a PS5. You can see you've not had the PS5, but you start having the joy of playing. You imagine all the times you've wanted it and you don't have it, and now you have a promise that you'll get it. You feel the joy. That kind of emotion is what you call joy. Joy is different from happiness. Happiness is temporal. It's just at instance what happened at a point in time. But joy is a continuous thing. Another thing you need to know about joy is that joy is a gift of God to His children. Joy, God is the one that gives us joy. You can't really get, sometimes, let's say the PS5, for example. After a while, you get bored and you put it down. That means there's no joy in that. He only gave you happiness. But if you look at something that makes you happy all the time, when you think about it, that is joy. So joy is one of the fruits of the Spirit. We can see all this in the quoted verses that we have here. How can we have the joy of this glory? One, have a journal, a joy journal. Get a book and every day write what you are what good thing God has done for you. Look at all the things God do for you every day. Take an account of good things God did. You can decide to write one each day or two. So just get a journal and put it down. Every day, think about a good thing God has done for you and put it in your journal. At the end of 1 year, you realize that you have 365 good things God has done for you in just 1 year. Another way we can have joy of His glory is to find something to be thankful for. This is similar to the joy journal, but this time around, you are not writing it down. You are just looking at everything that is around you. You are looking at everything that is happening, and you are seeing a reason to thank God. For example, let's look at what is happening in the world now. There's a pandemic, but you are alive. That's reason to thank God. You are still alive. A lot of people, there are so many things happening. You have a house you are living in. That's something to be thankful for. Even if you don't have, even if there's no house, you have life. You are still alive. That's why you can even experience what is happening. That is something to be thankful for. So every day, look for something to be thankful for. This will help you keep the joy of His glory. Another thing you can do to have joy of His glory is to say thank you to God. Every time you want to pray, spend time to thank God for what He has done already. Do start by asking. Before you ask for anything, make sure you have thanked Him for what He did for you. It will help you to always recall His goodness. Another thing you can do is to look for Bible verses that talk about joy. Like 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 16 to 18. But get your Bible, let's read it. So let's look at 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16. So it says, always be happy, never stop praying, give thanks whatever happens. This is what God wants for you in Christ Jesus. Can you see? Every time you give thanks, it creates joy in your heart. It reminds you of the goodness of God. Whatever happens, look for a reason to thank God, and I'm sure it will keep your joy. Number five, ask God and He will give you joy. One thing I want you to know as children is that you can talk to God about anything. God is a loving Father. He's always ready to listen to us. So if you want to be happy, if you want joy, ask God and He's going to give it to you. Number six, tell someone about Jesus Christ. There are a lot of people around you that don't know about Jesus, or some have just chosen to deny Him. So just tell someone about Jesus Christ. Just tell them Jesus loves you. That alone can make someone's day. There are a lot of people going through a lot of things, but you telling them about Jesus, just like Jesus loves you, Jesus cares for you, can put joy in people's hearts. Number seven, be dedicated to God's service. Do things that pleases God. Do things, read your Bible, have a relationship with God. Read your Bible to know God. Read your Bible to understand God. And before you do anything, think about it. If I can see God physically, what will He think about what I'm about to do? Will God be happy about what I'm about to do? Or will He not be happy with me, with what I'm about to do? If your answer is God is going to be happy with you, then you can go ahead and do it. But if you're not sure, then I don't think you should do it. Anything that make up your mind to do things that make God happy, and you will always be happy. Make up your mind to do not to do things that will not make God happy. That way, you'll be happy. So dedicate your life to God's service. Dedicate your life to pleasing God in all your ways, and you'll be very happy. Number eight, which is the last one I'm giving you. There are several ways to get to have the joy of glory, but I'm going to stop here for today. Number 8, always obey God's instruction. There's something I need to tell you that I've discovered a long time. Every time God instructs you is for your own good. If there's fire and someone is telling you, don't put your hand in fire, it's because the person does not want you to get burnt. Not because the person just does not like your face. No, it's because the person doesn't want you to get your hand burnt. The same way God instructs us. Every time God tells you not to do this, not to do that, it's because he loves you. He does not want you to get hurt. He does not want anything bad to happen to you. And as his children, he wants to protect you. Just like your mommy and daddy will not want you to do things that will hurt you. The same way God does not want you to do things that will hurt yourself. So always obey God's instruction. They are all for your own good to keep you safe. So you can only experience God, the fullness of joy in his presence. So always be in his presence. Remember our memory verse in Psalm 16, verse 11. So there's an invitation that Jesus has given out. Jesus is having a big party and is inviting all of us. He says, come experience unlimited joy of his glory today. You are all invited. Make sure you invite your friend to come to Jesus so that they can experience his glory. So before we conclude, is there any one of us that does not really agree with Jesus and now wants to agree with Jesus? You can just raise up your right hand with me and say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. Fill my heart with your joy. From now on, I want to follow you. Help me. Let me live my life to you. I accept you into my life. Let your name be glorified in my life forever. In Jesus' name. Wow, now you've come to Jesus. You just need to continue to live in him. Continue to experience his joy, and your joy will be full in Jesus' name. Amen. In conclusion, joy is a gift of the Holy Spirit that you receive as a child of God as long as you remain in him. Happiness is dependent upon temporary things and can be here today and gone tomorrow. So, thank you for listening. If you have any question, please send a mail to office@restorationhouse. I will take some time to answer all questions. It will be passed on to me and I will answer all such questions. Thank you.